Well, now Rihanna is telling Trump to stop the music.
That's right. Rihanna responded to a fan on Twitter who pointed out her song, Don't Stop the Music, was being played at a Trump rally. She took to Twitter to respond to the fan. And she actually wrote, not for much longer, me nor my people would ever be at or around one of those tragic rallies. So thanks for the heads up, Philip. So she's not having it.
Not having it.
But she would not be the first artist who actually asked the Trump campaign and administration to stop playing their music during rallies. Steven Tyler, among them, he actually tweeted about his song being played. And he said that this is not about Dems versus Republic at the time. He said, I do not let anyone use my songs without my permission. My music is for causes, not for political campaigns or rallies. So he made it a little more general. It wasn't just about Trump. It's the fact that they're using it without his permission and he doesn't want it to for any political campaigns.
Another one recently, too, according to the Hollywood Reporter, Pharrell Williams, he sent a cease and desist letter to Trump because his song Happy was played at a rally. So another example right there.
Yeah, that was according to the Hollywood Reporter that he sent that cease and desist letter. But yeah, I mean, we can go back even further, though. There's other examples of artists who just don't want any political affiliations with their music, including Sting. Adele, of course, and also Sting. He reportedly asked George W. Bush and Al Gore as well to stop playing his songs. He said he didn't want to get involved in U.S. politics because he, of course, is an Englishman. And then there was Bruce Springsteen, who asked Reagan back in the 80s to stop playing Born in the USA, as well as Foo Fighters, who asked John McCain not to play My Hero.